In this video, we look at a scanning app called JetScanner. It's a wonderful, simple, clean interface app that allows you to scan a range of different documents or import images from your photo library, convert them into PDFs. You're then able to upload those PDFs to a range of different other apps and cloud storage solutions, including Evernote, Dropbox, SkyDrive, and Google Drive.
So to make a new file, you either choose something from the camera roll or you take a new picture. I'll take a new picture. So receipt, picture, photo, whatever it might be. Take a photo of it. It then outlines the image where it thinks the corners are and gives you some simple editing tabs. So you can drag the corners depending on what you think. Now let's say your image was a bit off center on a bit of an angle. You can drag your corners in, and when you click the tick, it'll actually reframe that, so it stretched the image back out. So that's quite useful. So we click on the tick to accept those changes. Now this is my document, so that's the first page in the document. If you want to add a second page, you can either take another photo or go to your camera roll. So this time I'll add in a photo. I can choose more than one. Click done. Now we've got two pages in my document. If you want to have a look again at either of those pages, you just tap on the page and you get those simple options of cropping ratio, so we can crop the image again if we like. I'm going to cancel out of that one. Or there is a rotate button if you need to rotate the image. And there's also the delete option. So do you want to delete that image? I'm going to leave it there for the moment. So let's go back. Once I've got all the images I want in a particular document, I can then click on the PDF symbol up in the right hand corner and it will basically make a PDF for me. So let's just give it a name and it creates that PDF. So now that's done, takes you back to your main screen. You can see here's my first PDF document called Practice. And you can order your documents by date, by name, or by size. If you want to edit the document, just tap on it and you can delete, print, email, open in, or upload. Now there's plenty of options for open in, so Goodreader, all the usual ones that you probably have on your iPad, including Evernote, Dropbox, and then upload to. So you've got the four main options: Dropbox, Google Drive, SkyDrive, or Evernote. So there's some great options there for uploading your documents. When you want to make a new document, just choose one of your options. So this time I'll go camera roll. Let's choose a couple of images from here. Click on done. And there is an edit tab for this screen as well. So if I click on edit, I can either delete the page from this screen, or you get your classic reordering tabs, so you can click and drag and reorder the pages as well. So once you're finished, once again you click on that icon to give it a name. This one we'll call Photos. And now I've got two documents that'll appear on my main screen. Okay, so at the moment I've ordered them by date. If I ordered them by name, it should go in alphabetical order, which it does. And if I order by size, you can see they change the order there by size. So there's only a few settings tabs. If you click on in the top left hand side, you can configure the image resolution. So at the moment it's on medium. You can make it high or low. Obviously that'll change your file size. And then you've got three options for linking accounts. So you can link a SkyDrive, Evernote, or a Dropbox account. So you can do your configuration from that screen. The one major disadvantage I can see for JetScanner is once you've made a document, there doesn't seem to be a way to edit that document. So if you click on there, you get your options, open, open in. And when you open, it basically gives you a printing or an emailing option. You can have a look through your pages, but there are your only options. So you really have to make sure you get your document correct before you finish it off.
Okay, so let's get some conversation going on this app. Do you like this app, or do you have any other preferred scanning applications? Head across to the Facebook page, iPadagogy. Don't forget to follow the Twitter feed at i_pedagogy. Also, remember to subscribe for more excellent videos.